My name is Hiroki Matsuchi, and you are listening to or watching Bridges, a weekly showcase of a single content creator in Japan and their content. This is episode number 28, and today we are featuring Miyabi and Tomoko. Yuri and Miyabi. Oh, sorry guys, that's not right either. That's right. It's just Miyabi from her popular channel on YouTube, where she shares all sorts of interesting aspects of Japan and Japanese culture in a very sweet and endearing way. This is the first time we've featured a non-native English-speaking content creator on the show, and I'm really hoping to do this more often in the future. Miyabi does a great job showing us around her world, and it's quite nice to see Japan through her eyes. This next video is a fun mini-lesson on some common Japanese onomatopoeias, and is a great chance for beginners and experts alike to brush up on their Japanese. It also features Miyabi's famous opening line. Hi there, how are you today? Enjoy this next clip, guys.
Hi there, how are you today? 日本語は韓国語について世界で2番目に擬音語、擬声語、擬態語が多いと言われています。そしてそれらは辞書に載っているものだけでも2000語以上あるようで、私たちが日常よく使う語はその中で400から700語くらいと言われています。今日は私たちがよく使う語とその意味、そしてチャットなどで便利な顔文字を紹介します。
ニコニコ、ワクワク、やれやれ。小峰，王，不，
Have a good week. Bye for now.
Now, armed with your newly acquired Japanese language skill, you can now head out on the town, or something like that. And speaking of which, Miyabi's videos aren't just relegated to lessons about the Japanese language, but she also goes out and takes her video camera with her on her many excursions out and about town. This next clip is from a trip she took to a place called Tateyama. I've been seeing posters of this snow valley every winter for the past few years, and I've been dying to take a trip there. Only second to actually visiting the place is to be able to vicariously see the valley along with Miyabi. Enjoy this next one, guys.
実は落差は日本一なんですが、雪解けとか
So, we all love Valentine's Day, right? All the couples and the love and the affection. Right. This is always a popular topic of conversation every time February rolls around. And here we have, once again, Miyabi to explain to us the intricacies of celebrating Valentine's Day here in Japan. Now, of course, all you need is a date, I guess. Enjoy this next one, guys.
Hi there. How are you today?Saint Valentine's Day is around the corner, isn't it? In Japan, on this day, women give chocolates to men to express their affection. ところで皆さんは、私たちがこの日、本命の男性以外にもチョコレートを贈るって知ってますか？
好きな男性に贈るチョコレートを本命チョコと呼ぶのに対し、会社などで上司や同僚に渡すチョコレートを義理チョコと呼びます。これらの言葉はすでに定着しています。
その他にも近年、友チョコ、自分チョコという言葉をよく耳にします。
友チョコというのは主に同性の友達に対して友情の証として贈るチョコレートで、自分チョコというのは自分自身のために買うチョコレートのことです。
この時期のチョコレート売り場はいろんな商品が並べられていて、思わず自分の分も買いたくなってしまう気持ち、よくわかりますよね。ところで話は義理チョコに戻りますが、そもそも義理ってどういう意味かわかりますか？義理というのは日本的な情念、論理の概念の一つで、英語で正確に言い表すのは難しいと聞いたことがあります。 日本について書かれたある本によれば、封建社会の中で形成された義理の概念は、主従、親子、夫婦、兄弟、友人、時には敵や取引先という人間関係の中で最も重視される規範であり、強いて言えばこれらの関係の中で恩を受けた相手を思いやり、いたわり、時には自己を犠牲にしてまで相手の幸せを実現する決意のこととなっています。自己を犠牲にしてまでも相手の幸せを実現する決意、すごっ。でもすっごい美味しそう。薬局、コンビニ、スーパーなどで比較的安く売られているバレンタイン用のチョコレートは義理チョコになることが多いと思います。ある日本のメジャーなお菓子メーカーがまとめたデータによると、自分が犠牲になってまでも義理を重んじているようには見えないね。あ、早くチョコレート買いに行かなきゃ。ところでこのビデオの中で一体何回チョコレートと言ったでしょうか。正解した人にはみやびからスペシャルバレンタインチョコレートを贈ります。 Anyway, I hope you have a nice Valentine's Day. Bye for now.
So please check out this really sweet content creator and let her take you around Japan as a friend, so she says. Even though she claims not to be a teacher, that certainly is part of what she does on YouTube, and she does it well.And as the YouTube people say, please watch, rate, comment, and subscribe to Just Miyabi's channel. So that just about does it. And once again, thank you all for listening or watching episode number 28 of Bridges. Please get in touch with us over at bridges@wanwan.fm with any comments, questions, or suggestions for future content creators to be featured on the show.Once again, my name is Hiroki Matsuchi, and this is Bridges. And thank you for watching. See you next week, guys.